There's plenty of stuff in the universe that defies the human urge to categorize everything. I mean, is Pluto a planet? Is this a new species or subspecies? Man or woman? Green, blue, or teal? However, sometimes nature gives us a helping hand and provides a hard physical line distinguishing two things, like the difference between white dwarf stars, neutron stars, and black holes. These are the different possible corpses of dead stars, and what distinguishes them is how they hold themselves up against the inexorable attraction of gravity. Let's begin, though, with what makes something a star in the first place. Fusion of hydrogen. Below about 8% of the mass of the sun, a gas ball isn't hot and high pressure enough for hydrogen to fuse, and you get a failed star, essentially a really heavy version of Jupiter or Saturn. Above this dividing line are stars like red dwarfs, our sun, and so on, which use hydrogen and other fusion to keep themselves hot enough to stave off gravitational collapse. But eventually, stars run out of fuel for nuclear fusion and die. And when a star dies, it will turn into one of three very different and physically distinct things. If the star is small, its core will turn into a white dwarf, which is an object about the size of the Earth, almost as massive as the Sun, and is held up against gravity not by heat, but by electrons repelling each other due to the Pauli exclusion principle. This effect is essentially a star-sized version of how electrons fill subsequently bigger orbitals around an atom, because of a fundamental law of the universe that no two electrons can share the exact same state. If the star is bigger, its core will be too heavy for this kind of electron repulsion to hold it up against gravity, and instead it'll collapse even more until it's around 10 kilometers in size, all of its electrons and protons fuse together into neutrons, and it's held up instead by the nuclear repulsion between neutrons, as well as the neutron version of the Pauli exclusion principle, aka a neutron star. If the dying star is yet bigger still, or if two neutron stars collide and merge, its core will be too heavy for either the strong nuclear force or Pauli exclusion principle to hold it up against gravity, and it'll collapse until it's held up by, well, as far as we know, there's not anything left to hold up stuff this dense, and it'll collapse into a black hole. So when a star dies, what it turns into depends on its mass, and what distinguishes these star corpses from each other is what they're made of and how they hold themselves up against gravity. Or don't. But enough about space objects that have nice, clean, easy definitions. There's also a lot of stuff out there that doesn't fit nicely into boxes.
Like moons. We supposedly have a good definition for what a moon is, but our solar system is full of objects that fall into a weird gray area between moon and not moon. Come on over to Minute Earth to find out why our definition of moon might be broken.